Hi guys, I'm Dalia Zayed, and as you know me, I'm a great advocate and practitioner of brand strategy. Well, everything starts from the brand strategy. Guess what? You could do this amazing one, but when it comes to tactical and rolling out that thinking, it's not so great. The messages are so mixed up, are so confusing, or not targeting the right consumer. So, be it equity or tactical campaigns, creative is key. Absolutely. And I have to say, on a personal note, I really miss good creativity in these markets that we're working in at the moment. No offense, guys. But let me share with you a thought. If we want to better understand our audience, better understand what's going through their head, and why they're making these decisions, that could be creative, that will be in store, what type of communication that are we using? Yeah. So if we do understand that, that means we can shape our messaging to influence them to our side. Think of attention, persuasion, long-term memory. Think of all the clutter that we have out there, clueless, noisy messages. So here comes neuromarketing. Absolutely. You might have not heard about it. You might have heard it from me a couple of times, or you have attended my previous session this year on neuromarketing. But yeah, truth is, it is an expensive tool. Yeah. But there are tips out there. There are cheaper ways to run it. But at the same time, if there's learning, why don't we grab it? I've been very impressed with the work I've read, the conferences I've attended with the global community, NMSBA, if you want to check it out. I have downloaded material from conferences that I was not able to attend in person, and it's just amazing, amazing work of trying out a lot of stuff just to get a better understanding what makes that brain tick. I loved it. It's, you know, myth buster for me in many, many levels. And after, you know, so many years of working on communication, advertising that leveraged the brand strategy, well, I'm surprised at a few things. One of the highlights for me was central branding, for example. It is very, very underused. And I think possibly the trigger for me was Martin Lindstrom's great book, Brand Sense, which I love, and I always advocate for people to read it. You know, think about it. 83% of brands use visual. But you know what? As a human being, we can only process 140 or less bits of data. So what are we doing here? Why are we not looking at the other senses? Yeah, we have five senses, by the way. One of which is audio, and that would make you think, why am I doing this audio versus a video to promote my upcoming session, right? There is a reason for that, okay, on the audio level, such an amazing sense, and how to work it out. So you want to know what the fuss is about and share ideas on your bottlenecks in communication and I chat to you more about how you enhance it? Join me in the upcoming session. The Untold Stories of Neuromarketing.